Hello friends and family, and welcome to my channel. It's a sunny, crisp, cool day in the GMS garden, and I think it's the perfect time to start to bring all my trees into the greenhouse. So yeah, let's start this episode. So first step is to remove all the trees from the bench so I can move the bench indoors to my greenhouse. So yeah, let's do that. It's so practical because the trays comes with them, so I don't have to carry them one by one. My red leaf maple is turning nice now, I think. 3 pieces of dwarf rhododendron starting to get nice. An azalea that's not doing very well, due for repotting come spring. A small maple, I think it's called orange green. It's this year's purchase, so it's just been truck chopped once. My first tree ever, it's a Pinus mugo, and it's called Kasten's Wintergold. Yeah, it's starting to develop quite nice. My first Yamadori, it's a Scots pine. Been working on it for 5 years now, I think, maybe 6. An azalea, or azalea, I think it's pronounced in English. This year's purchase, so nothing worked on it yet, but yeah, I would say potential anyway. An IKEA spruce that I've been working on for 5 years, and yeah, I don't know, maybe it needs some serious restyling. Two Japanese black pines, I'm not sure if I'm growing them for bonsai yet. They are like a backup for my Niwaki trees up in the hill. So on to the next bench. This one is 3 meters instead of the other ones I have started to disassemble, which is 4 meters. So I'm going to build my overwintering bench a little bit different this year, which means that I need a few of these as well. So let's check them out. This one is a ornamental crab apple tree, which I potted up this last winter, so it's been in a pot for approximately 1 year. My little silver birch forest for free in the free pot, and the seedlings I collected in a pot made this spring. This is a 7 euro hornbeam. I got this potted up this spring as well. The pot is the one my Chinese elm came in, so total cost when doing it 7 euro. Dawn redwood forest, they are hanging on to their leaf quite long in the winter and looks quite ugly. But I'm gonna clean it up any day, and I'm sure it's gonna bounce back like crazy come spring. A Chinese linden tree I've been growing for 4 years. It used to have one big trunk in the middle, but there were no back budding at all. So I'm going for this, what is called fan shaped design for this one. Right now there are 2, 4, 6, 7, 8, that's like 10 different branches to choose from going forward. That will be done in spring. Oh, this one is just too heavy. The big hornbeam forest, I'm happy with the development, although I think it's very slow. This is a common linden tree. It has huge leaves, so I think I'm gonna grow it primarily for the winter silhouette. My Chinese elm, which I repotted this spring, and I have done a few videos on it. For those that wonder if Chinese elm is a indoor tree that needs to be protected from snow, the answer is no. Just a cutting from the big leaf linden tree. I'm always trying, and most of the time it doesn't succeed, but this was 1 centimeter wide cutting, and it has rooted quite nice. So in 10 years, a nice tree. Another azalea I bought this year, and have a long way to go until a nice tree. A silver birch tree I got from my mother's garden. Initially it was planned to put in the forest, but it's just out of proportion. So I put it in a clay pot I had at home. So this one is with zero cost for me. The ornamental apple tree that will get a new pot come spring. I will show you the pot later when we're in the greenhouse. This one was spending the spring in the greenhouse and wasn't got that much pollinated. But at least, there's nice small apples, just 5 of them. But now I know that if I want to start them early, I will need to pollinate them by hand. This one is a Cornus alba, a really wonderful red wood. And I think it has a quite big leaf, so it's also grown for a beautiful winter silhouette. I only had it for 2 years, I think, so lots of work to do on this one come spring. Another hornbeam tree that I had over and put in a pot some 4 or 5 years ago as well, and it's really starting to ramify, and could be a nice tree in the future. So let's continue building the indoor bench then.
Overwintering bonsai can be a topic of much concern for beginners. I have seen hundreds of well-meaning beginners taking their temperate trees indoors when first frost hits. Unfortunately, in most cases, this end up in dead trees. The best overwintering setup is pretty much dependent on your local conditions, what soil mix you are using, and of course, species of tree. This is why I often recommend people to reach out to local bonsai growers and see what they are doing. Here I will explain a little bit about how I do it for my temperate trees. I do not consider my solution being the best for everyone or every tree. The weather in coastal western Sweden, where I live, is, as most of western Europe, dry in summer and humid in winters. In midwinter, we often see temperatures go well below minus 10 degrees Celsius for a long period of time, often with little or no snow to protect the trees. The issue here is not the cold itself. The issue is the root ball being completely frozen for a long period of time. On sunny late winter days, the trees really need a drink. Needless to say, trees cannot drink ice. So in this time of the year, there are a risk of dehydration. The very same time of the year, the greenhouse gets up above zero, sometimes as high as 10 degrees Celsius. This thaws the root ball just enough to give them the quick, much needed drink. We also have very rainy and wet springs, just above freezing temperatures. These cold and wet conditions put the trees at risk for root rot. In my greenhouse, this is not an issue, as the trees are protected from rain. One huge benefit I see with my overwintering regime is that I can start working on my trees earlier than others. To me, that is the time of the year when nothing is going on in the garden and I have a lot of time available to do this work.
So I know that in here in my greenhouse it was very full last winter and I have gotten myself a few new trees. So I have taken all my smaller trees in bonsai pots and made a very temporary solution here.
As you may have noticed already, I grew a lot of my trees in development in big plastic pots. The big benefits of this, besides the cost savings on expensive bonsai pots, is much faster development. Once a tree is put in a shallow pot, it develops so much slower. These pots hold a very heavy organic soil mix. Besides that organic soil is so much cheaper than non-organic materials, I do believe this is the fastest way to develop trees. Believe it or not, most trees in nature grow in heavy organic soil. However, the thick, moist-holding organic soil makes the trees even more susceptible to root rot. I would not dare to leave these pots outdoors for a full frozen winter and wet humid spring. But with my overwintering regime and full control over the water they receive, I am not that worried. During my 6 years working with bonsai, I have only lost one temperate tree in winter. That was a Japanese black pine, stored under the benches and forgotten to water. Obviously, there were a reason for that particular tree to end up in that particular spot. One being lack of space, and the other one was that this one was just not one of my favorites.
So it's 2:15 and the sun just disappeared over the mountain. That's how it's like to live in Sweden close to the winter solstice. In less than 1.5 hours it will be pitch black, so I need really to move on here. So let's do this fast then. So I did get all of them in, and I did it just before it's getting pitch black here. And I'm so cold, need to go in and heat up. I will get back to you another day. So it's another sunny day in the GMS garden. Outside now is minus 5 degrees, but inside the greenhouse is up to 2 below zero. The trees are no longer covered in snow, and I go through them, and if one of them looks a little bit dry, I put just a small amount of snow on top of the soil, and it will give the tree drink when it needs to. Before I end this episode, I want to share a big thanks to Jason Hanrahan at the Bonsai Garden. I will put a link to his channel up above. Recently he had a giveaway contest and I made it. So thanks a lot, Jason. I have a Bonsai Basics book. I'm really stoked about that. I've been reading through it a little bit. And I think especially the care guides, the species guide is very good. So yeah. Thanks a lot, Jason. Please make sure to give him a subscription. Until next time, friends, thanks a lot for watching. Take care, stay safe. Bye.